So is it good now?
Yeah, it vibrates a lot more.
Oh yeah, girls will like that.
Oh yeah, yeah.
What are we doing today?
Put speakers in.
Speakers?
Yeah.
What, are the old ones busted or something?
No, they're just stock, and these are kickers, which are a lot better.
So what, they go in there, yeah?
Yep, they go right behind the door. The two front doors have speakers, and then the trunk right near the strut tower has speakers.
The strut... Oh, we were in the strut tower before, right? Yeah. Right back here.
You can see the speaker in the coilover video.
Yeah, that's right, that's right. Cool. All right. This is your door. How do you take yours off?
Bunch of random nuts and bolts and clips, and there's a clip here. Should have a clip tool, but I don't know where mine is.
All right.
So, there we go.
Yeah, see? All right.
I thought it was a Christmas tree, but it's not.
So cool.
That one. There's one up in here.
Like gum up in there too or something.
Yeah, there's a
oh, no.
Parked under a tree.
A tree's trying to plant itself in your car.
And then this is a Phillips head. And this thing comes off.
What do you mean this thing comes off? How are you getting... Oh, it pulls out? The entire thing pulls out? Okay, I see.
Yep.
Have you taken your door apart before?
Yeah. Well, okay. I did put some crappy speakers in there before.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So you're actually, you're upgrading your upgrade.
Yeah. That's it.
That's it?
Yep.
So now you just pull.
Now I got a pry one. Pop it off.
Really? That seems like a... All right. Do you need help with this?
That is connected. Plug here.
Yep.
For the window motor.
Here, I'll hold it.
Cool. And that's that.
Alright.
That's it.
Cool. So this is the inside, yeah?
This was the plug that went into the window switch.
Okay.
That will be my door handle.
Yeah.
Instead of cutting the stock wires and hard wiring the wires for the speaker directly into that, you can just put these on there and these plug directly in there, like that.
Cool.
And that way you don't have to cut anything.
Yeah.
So.
All right, so just taking this out, what are we doing? Just the three on the outside, it looks like?
Yep, three on
here,
the outside.
Here.
Nope, just these three.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Reusing the bracket. And these are Kenwoods. They're good, but the kickers are better, so. And it's out.
That was like really super simple, dude.
See, and then this is the wires that the speakers come with, and they just plug right into there.
Cool. All right. Sweet. Yeah. And what do the new ones look like? The new ones.
The new ones?
Yeah, these are the new ones. Where are the new ones? These ones. Let's compare these suckers.
All right. So there's the Kenwoods.
Yeah.
And this is the kicker.
Cool.
You can tell the kicker's a little more beefy.
It's interesting. This one like has these extra little cables, and then this one, the design, it's completely removed them.
Yeah.
Or they just never needed them in the first place.
I think they hided them or hid them a little better.
Hided?
Hided.
They hided. Hidey. Oh. So these are your goodies.
These are my goodies.
The electronic goodness.
Yeah, they're like wire connectors.
Okay.
So I'm gonna connect it to here so I can plug it into the stock pigtail.
Cool.
Do I want the blue or do I want the red?
Do you want to know what it is?
I'll go with the red.
You want the red pill?
Yeah. I don't need the blue pill.
I can never figure out which pill's which.
I don't even know who the red pill is.
What? Matrix? The Matrix.
Unfortunately, no one can be told what the Matrix is.
I would
say that the blue pill is for old men. So I got these attached.
Alright.
Now I'm gonna wrap them with tape just to be safe.
Gotcha.
Cool.
This is like a plug and play install.
Basically, yeah.
Like, I'm sure people will pay like $400 for some dude to do this.
Oh yeah. Like, it's ridiculous. That's why I like doing things myself.
Yeah, me too, shoot. Like in that one video with OCMD, right? With the rat rod, the guy selling it. And I'm just like really, we should build a rat rod.
I was actually thinking, let's find a motor for your Corvette.
Ooh.
And let's build that.
We could do that.
Get that thing all cleaned up and running again.
See, I would like it if it was like pushing 400 horsepower. That'd be nice. Yeah.
But the holes for the screws don't line up. So I'm just gonna cut the prongs off.
With a razor blade. Is this what they do in the shop?
Oh yeah.
I'm just kidding, I do the same thing.
Cause I'm never putting the stock speakers back in anyway, so.
Sure, yeah.
I always lose track of which one's lined up. There we go. That's the way we need it. There we go.
That is like so simple and straightforward.
She's on. And that's it. Now put the door panel back on.
Yeah.
Wait, first see if it works.
Cool.
Word.
Yay!
Now I can actually turn my bass up.
Yeah.
Because these speakers can handle it. My little baby speaker. I'm weird.
Cool. So now we gotta take apart the back, right?
Yep, this pops off very easily.
Yeah.
Boom.
It's like right there.
Yep.
It's so simple.
Yep.
It's so funny because it's so much easier than like your coilover.
Oh, yeah. Attach the wire connectors.
You're just crimping it, right?
Yep.
Cool.
Cool. And then wrap them with electrical tape. Extra support. Alright, let's get these ones. Yep. Cool. That's it.
Cool.
Then we just gotta make sure it works.
Yeah.
Boom.
Boom.
That's it.
Awesome. Yay!
Now you can jam out.
So stay tuned.
Thanks for watching this week's episode of Mills Garage. Make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you next week.